such a good service because instead of having 8 hours on a train, you just sleep through it. So I am really, really excited about getting a sleeper train. I find the train really relaxing anyway, like I always like nearly fall asleep even when sitting up in the chairs. So this is like my heaven. It's like live ASMR to me being on a train and getting to sleep there. So I'm going with my friend Lauren, who we went to nursery together when we were like 1 or 2, and we've grown up together, you know, like we went to primary school, high school, everything together. So this is really cool to go on this trip with her. It's gonna be so much fun. We've actually never gone away together apart from with our families together, you know, but never us two. So we're gonna cause some serious mischief. Also, we're staying in a hotel on the beach, and it is the most beautiful place I have ever seen. So I can't wait to share that with you guys as well. But again, thanks so much to Great Western Railway for gifting these tickets, and I can't wait to take you guys on this trip with me. I'm gonna obviously be making it ASMRified, so hopefully it's also relaxing to you. Anyway, let's get on the blooming train. So here we are at London Paddington Station. Just found our train, our Great Western Railway train, and getting to our little sleeper. This is our room. I'll give you a little tour. So it's bunk beds. I was on the bottom bunk and the lost bar was on the top. It was really, really cute. There was little stairs so the lost could get up to the top bunk, hidden away. The beds were so, so comfortable. Honestly, they were so comfortable. And obviously this like rock of the train, like, it was like ASMR in real life, really. There was a wardrobe with the coat hangers so you could put your outfit for the next day on it. Got free water bottles as well. Your face before bed. And a little shelf up there for the top bunk person. The pillows were really comfortable. There was a lamp there and places to plug your phone in, etc. And then we literally just went straight to sleep, really. Although I couldn't switch the right light off. I thought I'd quickly show you the little bar bit as well. You could get like unlimited food and drink, which was really nice. They brought a cup of tea for the morning as a little wake up, and then we went off to Newquay. Well, we had to get off at the bar first and change to get to Newquay. But this is when we arrived. That's our hotel where we stayed, right down there. This is Tolcarne Beach. This is a view from a little beach house we stayed in, like just for a few hours while our little house was getting prepared for us to move in. But look how beautiful, beautiful the beach is. It's like a little private beach. So, so pretty. Spacious wooden floors, so nice. And yeah, there's a little wardrobe here and a fridge with some champagne in and a jug of milk so you can make cups of tea. There's a picnic basket so you can take it to the beach, on the beach. There was little robes and slippers, which was such a cute touch. And we wore them like the whole time. The bed was moved, so it was ridiculous. View from the bed. Sculptures and stuff around the gardens. I went and stood next to it so you could see the size of it. Then there was this sleeping sculpture, which was just amazing, even more surreal in person. It says, "Shh, my maid is sleeping. Please do not climb in the fences, step on her moss blanket, or disturb her dreams. Thank you." She looks so peaceful. Insect hotel, that was it.
This was the grey lady. It was actually really hard to capture because she kind of blends in with the surroundings and the trees, but you can kind of make out her silhouette. The grey lady. This was the flower. Some good Instagram photos there, as you can imagine. I've never been in like a flower field or anything before, and it was just overwhelmingly pretty, you know, like nature at its finest. Even though they were planted, but you know what I'm saying. Oh yeah, we found these coins that were all in this tree. I just thought it looked really cool. Loads and loads of coins. All embedded in it, in the back. I love the texture given, like the rust that you could see on the coins. Thought it was really cool. This really cool shot of a bumblebee. If you look at it closely, I play again, it will slow it down. You can see it flying towards the camera. I thought it looked so cool. Actually made me like back up a little bit because I was looking at the camera screen. It was so cool. Here's the sign saying lost to valley of the jungle. It just sounds so magical. This was the jungle area. Thing just felt like you're in a different country. It was really cool. We didn't know what to expect. We thought there'd be like a few palm trees or something, but it was way more than that. There was so much to look at, and like a swamp area, and yeah, just really cool plants, giant leaves, and made you feel like you're in a rainforest. There was such a long walk around all of the places. I didn't actually film it, but there's also like a place where within the gardens the sheep and stuff walk free and you can walk among them, and pigs and everything. It was really cool. But me and Lauren love kind of nature walks, like we love going through forests and stuff, so this was like also a bridge, which you'll see in a second, like a rope bridge you could walk across that made you feel like you're in I'm a Celebrity, get me out of here. This is it. Also, Lauren was being typical Lauren and jumped on it all the way down, and the people in front of us were like screaming in terror. It's typical Lauren. But it was really cool. It looks so mysterious. Fear of heights. There is something like this though. this was like a beautiful bit that we sat out for a while. It was just so pretty. If I lived around there, I would definitely like sit there, bring my work and work from there. Oh my god, it'd be amazing. This was the cool swamp bit. We felt like there should be like a crocodile jump out. And it just looked like that, you know. Oh no, this is the valley. Yeah, the valley. Lost Valley. This was home time. This was our view from our Airbnb. And we just packed up to leave. Which was very sad.
So I am back home now. I am shattered. I have had I'm just very tired. A lot of travelling. But I had the best trip I've ever had in my whole life. I can't even, I'm so glad I can share so much of it with you guys, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I kind of wanted to mix relaxing themes like the beach and stuff. I just thought it'd be a nice way to bring in ASMR like sounds and elements within a vlog, if you know what I mean. So I hope you found it relaxing, and thanks so much again to Tolcarne Beach Village and Great Western Railway for gifting the train journey and for gifting the stay at the beach village. It was incredible. I cannot recommend both of those enough. The Tolcarne Beach Village was the most beautiful place I've ever seen or been to now. I can't believe I've been there, but yeah. And the train journey, the sloop train, was the best way to travel, honestly. Fall asleep and then you wake up and you're at your destination. It was just perfect. So I will link both in the description.